starters for today's game. First, for the visitors from Triton. Wearing number four, a 5'5" junior, Taren Yates. Wearing number 14, a 5'4" sophomore, Kinsey Atkins. Wearing number 22, a 5'5" senior, Emma Hepler. Wearing number 24, a 5'11" senior, Abbey Viers. Wearing number 32, a 5'10" senior, Lexia Hostrawser. The Trojans are coached by Adam Heckaman. Now, here are the starters for your LaVille Lancers. Wearing number 12, a 5'8" sophomore, Jaelyn Bules. Wearing number 22, a 5'5" sophomore, Orion. Wearing number 24, a 5'5" junior, Cassie Lutz. Wearing number 25, a 5'10" sophomore, Lucy Shirk. And wearing number 31, a 5'11" senior, Allison Meadows. The Lancers are coached by Daniel Plenninger.
Hey, don't yell travel.
Say yes, no.
That was a moving screen.
For the TCU Bi-County Tournament, as the host, Lady LaVille Lancers, are hosting here. This is the Triton Lady Trojans coming in to try to go up 2-0 on this team on the season. They won back 46-31 as Triton leads here 2-0 early in the first quarter. You got Kinsey Atkins out there with Taren Yates, Emma Hepler, Abbey Viers, and Lexia Hostrawser. You got Lauren Edison, Allison Meters, Cassie Watts. Haley and Kwiatkowski, and number 25 Lucy Shirk are the five out there for the Lancers. Shirk now in the corner, goes back on over. Edison with it, kicks it, driving shot there off the mark for Cassie Watts. Yotes bringing up now for the Trojans. Across the half-court line, goes over to Kinsey Atkins on the right side. Viers comes up to the high post. Yates had a look, she'll drive, wanted it there. Kicks it back to Viers atop the key. Atkins will let it reset. Hepler now drives. Trying to find a way to get around here, Kaden.
Yeah, they got to be looking to shoot the ball here. Abbey Viers is the only scorer in this one so far.
Hostrazer goes up, she'll draw the foul and go to the line for two. And the foul's going to be on number 25, Lucy Shirk. So Hostrazer plays really well in this gym in her career.
Always seems to turn it on at LaVille.
Makes the first free throw there.
Is there any connections?
Could be. Of course, this Triton Lady Trojans team was a runner-up last season on their second trip to the Bi-County Championship and lost to champion Bremen, who won their back-to-back championship last season. And so Hostrazer sets for a second free throw. It's up and rattles in. So Triton takes a 4-0 lead. Kwiatkowski will bring it up. She'll work. Trying to get somebody freed up. Goes to Addyson. Try to save it. It's going to go out of bounds.
Blue
ball. And so go to Triton.
Good defensive stand there for the Trojans.
Fuzia.
Kinsey Atkins now will bring it up. It froze us for a second. We're still Hostrazer on the left wing. Up top to Emma Hepler. Kick out to Atkins on the right wing. Hostrazer trying to get position down low. Goes on top. And that's going to be Kwiatkowski. Going to jump the route. She goes up strong. The fast break off the mark. Yates with the rebound. Going to push it herself now. They've got numbers. Quickly on up. Viers. Hostrazer. Bank is closed. Hostrazer's put back is good. And Triton starts off with a 6-0 run here with 4:29 left in the first quarter.
Lucky break for the Trojans there. Well, the fast break missed from LaVille.
And it was a nice job by Yates to kind of look up front and a good pass from Viers to Hostrazer. So that was a good look there. Yates jumps the route again. She's going to take off the fast break. She'll go, steps, goes up strong. Bank is closed. Goes out of bounds. It'll stay here with Triton. As Cassie Watts was in there on the defense for the Lady Lancers. Atkins to inbound. Yates cycles up top. She'll go to her on the far side. Back to Atkins on the right wing.
Back cut. Good. Good.
Viers rotates up top. Going to get a blocking foul, looks like, on Addyson, possibly. And it is. Be her first, team's third of the first half. Yates down the corner. Beats Hostrazer down low. She'll fade away. Can't get the roll. Viers is going to fight for the rebound and comes away with it. Pass too low for Yates, and Triton turns it over. And a full timeout now for the Lady Lancers. Of course, following this game, we'll have the boys. A lot of action around here for the TCU Bi-County Tournament. No JV, of course, this week. Triton favored in this one here, 46-31. After that win earlier in the season, and they won 38-29. So Triton's kind of had LaVille's number the last several years, the last 15 years. 20-2 is the record. And as far as opponents go, Triton's a little bit tougher opponents, 138-121 the record, and LaVille 78-75. So
when you look at LaVille, LaVille has only 2-8. They've only played 10 games. The Trojans have played 17 coming into this one, so that plays a big part in the
Next week, if I read right, LaVille's got like four games. They'll have three games back-to-back-to-back. It's Daniel Puninger. We'll have his work cut out for him. So Triton retakes the floor following the timeout. We'll see what they draw up. Kwiatkowski will inbound as LaVille looks to get on the board here on this possession. 3:40 to go in the first. Kwiatkowski in the corner. Addyson works it on over to Watts now. In the corner there to Shirk.
Little travel, yep.
Unfortunate play coming up short for LaVille. Triton gets the ball back.
Oh, 1-3-1. We saw Triton struggle against this defense against Bremen on Saturday.
Here's down the low block, kicks back up to Kinsey Atkins. She'll split the defenders, pull up jumper inside the arc. Can't get the roll. Good look. Goes out of bounds. Oh, they're going to call a foul.
Yes.
That's going to be on Abbey Viers. As I missed the substitution, Faith Rock checking in for LaVille. As Watts will bring it up. He's down to Shirk. She'll put a shot up off the front iron. No good rebound to Hostrauser. Yates gets it now. She'll take off. Slows it down as the offense takes shape. Ooh. High pass. Viers can't get position. Yates tries to save, but it goes out of bounds. Good effort by Yates to kind of back up the pass there to try to keep the ball in play. As LaVille now goes back with the ball, trailing by 6 here in this first quarter. Kinsey Atkins finding for Faith Rock, gets it. Addyson down the left wing up top. She'll go on over to Kwiatkowski. Addyson gets freed up, goes down to Faith Rock. She'll back down Viers. Nice job by Viers on the defense. Shirk gets it, goes up strong. We're going to get a foul.
That's on Abby Viers. That's her second.
That'll be a tough break for the Trojans.
Yep, her second.
So she'll be sitting, so they'll bring in Jaelyn Bules, looks like. And LaVille's now on the board there following the make from Lucy Shirk. Addyson Viers and Jaelyn Bules both checking in. Broadcasting this one from the couch as the second one goes in. They got you a comfortable seat there, don't they, Kenny?
No.
Uh-oh.
I'm just standing.
Scoreboard one. Maybe you stand. Well, hey.
Well, our seats are just fine. Thank you for asking, Kenny.
Yeah, they're a little stiff. I don't think you'd like them. I think standing up's probably better.
Actually, the computer's got the comfy chair.
Oh, there you go. Kinsey Atkins gets a look from outside. She'll fire away and puts it in. Kinsey Atkins with the 3 ball to go as Triton extends the lead out to 7.
LaVille still without a field goal in this first quarter.
And a little miscue there with LaVille as they'll turn it over and Triton takes back over. Oh. Atkins can't corral the hot pass from the freshman Addyson Viers. With a minute 32 to go, LaVille gets the ball back.
I know Coach Heckman is not happy about that play. That's just a lack of execution there.
Addyson now will feed down low to Faith Rock. Jaelyn Bules has the defense, and Rock loses it, and it'll go back to Triton. Good defense there by Jaelyn Bules to go straight up there and force the defender to disrupt that shot. I don't know, Ryan's doing more running than some of these girls are on the screen.
what's he got?
Addyson Viers now up top.
Short order cook?
No.
No. Oh, and Taren Yates nails one from beyond the arc. Triton now, largest lead of the ball game is up to 10.
Trying to fix my Wi-Fi light bulbs. They want to just blink when you turn them on.
Watts goes defeated as she changed her mind on the way up. Atkins now at 45 seconds to go. Back-to-back threes for the Trojans. See if LaVille tries to do something to counter that. Bules gets it. Thought about it. Goes up strong. Can't get it to go. Shirk with the rebound. These are for Kwiatkowski.
I thought she was going to the corner.
Yates intercepts. She takes off. Pull-up jumper and transition off the mark. Rebound out. It goes to Watts. Watts now trying to get his position. Emma Hepler. Going to call a foul on the body. As Allison Meters checks in.
That'll be Emma's first, team's third.
I am saying that right, Meters.
I don't know. Meters?
Meters? Kenny, you're there. Did you hear it?
No, I didn't.
Okay, that works.
I'll catch it later.
Lucy Shirk, back iron. Rebound, Addyson Viers. I got to go. 3 seconds. 2 seconds on the clock. Yates forces one up at the buzzer. Oh, it went in and out. Shades of Butler Duke on that one. Gordon Hayward felt the same way, I think. As Triton takes a 10-point lead in the second quarter, we saw a lot of good things there, Kaden, as we were kind of trying to get our gears all set after I apparently didn't hit save on the stats for us, but oh well.
Yeah, Triton's playing. They've come out playing very hard on the defensive end, only allowing LaVille to 2 points, and those were off of free throws. So, I mean, they've came out with intensity. They're looking like they want to play, they want to win, they want to move on to this next round of the Bi-County.
And, you know, this is a team that tasted what the championship can bring a season ago. And, you know, this is a group that, you know, this is pretty much the same group that was out there a season ago as, you know, you're missing Jess Soriano and Alexa Viers were the other two that were playing because Whitney Miller just hurt her shoulder there a few weeks before that. So this group here was the group on the floor, and a lot of these girls that are playing right now were the focal point of that team. Got in their way to a championship a season ago.
Yeah, well, you lose a Viers, you gain a Viers. So, Alexa's gone, but Addyson is.
Yep, so well, you technically didn't lose a Viers. You may have gained a doll. Oh, you know, you got a doll. You still got a doll on the team.
Yeah, you lost a doll, gained another doll.
Gained another doll. You got a Faulkner. You got to add a Faulkner in there. Biggest thing you lost was a Soriano.
Yeah.
So like I said, this team, a lot of familiar faces out there. These girls know what it takes in this tournament. They're going to be hungry for this one. Hot pass into Addyson Viers. Banks open for the freshman. As Triton takes a 14-2 lead. And this one. Watts on over to Shirk. Yates, can she get another one? Almost got a piece. So she still comes with it. Nice job by Yates, but she's going to get
help. Help.
Caught there, and Bules will get called for a foul.
Bules is first.
Triton's 14 foul.
Yeah. 4-2. It's a foul count right now.
And Kenny's appreciating the screen shot for the scoreboard as OCR just does not like that scoreboard.
Uh-oh. I'd fight it most of the night.
Probably just easier to do it this way.
Of course, appreciate Kenny driving up to LaVille and Orion's comfy, not very comfy couch, Kenny. Don't worry. It's not comfortable at all. It's okay.
I haven't seen Trent yet. Where's he sitting?
He's right beside me.
Hot pass.
Oh, there he is. Oh, no.
He's
their camera guy down there.
Yep.
What?
We set Alexa off.
Well, Bules thought about it. Hands off. Kinsey Atkins now back on top to Taren Yates. Back to Atkins on the right wing. She'll drive, goes to feed to Hostrawser down low. No good there. As LaVille will take over, 7:04 to go to the second.
Looked like Kinsey thought Lexi was going to go down. Lexi thought, I need to come up to get a pass. And just miscommunication, ball ends up out of bounds.
Watts kicks on over to Addyson. Quickly feeds Faith Rock down in the low block. Goes up strong, can't get that one to roll. Addyson Viers hands off to Taren Yates. Yates now takes off, quick lip to Bules. Hostrawser trying to get position down there in the low block as well. She'll rotate up top to the high post. And she'll get it from Kinsey Atkins.
Try and get into the 2-1-2 defense, working against this 1-3-1. Oh.
All just kind of a little too low of a pass there as Watts gets it. She'll retreat back to let the offense catch up and get down there and get their half-court set going. Back, Addyson for three, can't get it to go. Shirk with the rebound, backing down Hostrawser, and she'll go to the line for an ammo opportunity after their first made field goal of the ball game.
And Shirk has all 4 points so far for the Lancers.
And a chance to get five on this one, and she was perfect from the line on her first trip. Zim Hepler will check in for Kinsey Atkins. So three seniors on the floor for Triton. Shook's free throw. She continues perfection from the line. Has a lead now down 14-5. Emma Hepler goes to feed Bules. She'll work down low, thought about it. Kicks back to Hepler. Addyson not giving her any leeway for a shot on the outside. Hostrawser now trapped in the corner. Yates, quick feed to Bules. Kick out. Hepler catch and shoot threes up. And can't get there short of the mark. Addyson Viers with the put back. The freshman's got four.
Good job by Addyson. Stay with it. She saw the miss. Remember where she needed to be.
Have you caught that travel there?
Yeah, there it is.
Okay, I was going to say, I know my math is not very good, but I do remember saying 14-5. So try and pushing that lead out to 11. They get the ball back here. 5:25 to go in the second quarter. Hostrawser around the side of the arc, works back. Yates feeds Addyson Viers all by herself in the low block. And we'll get a blocking foul on LaVille. That one's going to be called on Shirk. And it is.
Her second.
Team's fourth.
It's going to be a big loss if they take her out. She has all 5 points.
Looks like they'll have a couple girls checking in on the Addyson Viers. First free throw is a make as Triton get into the line twice in this one. And they didn't get there at all until late in the fourth quarter at Bremen on Saturday.
Yeah, that's one area of the game I think they need to continue to try to build off of is getting to the line more. I mean, they, I think in their last three games combined, have shot under 10 free throws.
That's the thing I think these girls would like to change because, I mean, this is a group that can shoot fairly decent from the free throw line.
Smith with it.
And she just checked in. I believe Kwiatkowski was the other one to check in. Meters, Rock. And Addyson, the other three out there for the Lady Lancers. Hostrawser, Yates, Hepler, Bules, and Addyson Viers. As Faith Rock goes up strong, she'll get fouled by Bules now. That'll be the second one on her.
Yep.
Sixth. Team fouls on the Trojans. As Faith Rock goes to the line, LaVille's been perfect by the hand of Lucy Shirk. Faith Rock will get set in there. First shot's up and in. Kinsey Atkins now will check in for Bules. That'll be a tough one there with two fouls and no Abbey Viers until the second half. Rock gets in position off the mark there. Going to call an air ball and give it to Triton.
First missed free throw for the Lancers.
Atkins works through that. 1-3-1. Hostrawser back to Yates. Atkins, corner three. Can't get that one to go. And Emma Hepler might run it down. Feeds it back. Atkins there to catch it. Back to Hepler. In the corner. Catch and shoot. Can't get it to go. Rebound's going to go to Lily Smith. Kwiatkowski will check in. 4:15 to go here in the second quarter. Triton leads by 12.
Triton is winning this quarter 6-4. On the scoreboard. Straight up, straight up.
Meters now goes good. Up. Nice job by Viers. Go straight up. Kaden, she heard you.
I think so. Kenny, do you have my audio playing out loud over there?
Atkins hits from the outside again. That's her second made three-pointer. As Triton pushes the lead out, 21-6.
I did just get a
Trojans
glimpse.
Trojans want to move on bad.
I just got a glimpse of the halftime graphic, and Kaden will be happy. For the Twitter.
Oh, perfect. No. That sounds lovely.
Yates now with it. Gets it around the attack line there. Feeds down low to Addyson Viers. The freshman has to feed into the corner. Emma Hepler back to Atkins. She'll try again from three.
Nope.
A little too strong there. Rebound's going to go to Addyson. And she'll kick it off to Smith, who'll leave for Kwiatkowski, and she'll bring it up now for the Lady Lancers.
Her feet weren't set, and she was thinking about the girl running at her the whole time. wasn't focused on the shot. Oh, I thought she traveled.
Meter shot off Mark Yates with another rebound. In transition here. Cross court, Kinsey Atkins. Back on top to Hepler, back to Yates. Down to Viers in the low block. The freshman kicks back out. Hostrauser now on the right elbow. Back to Viers. Viers up and can't get the roll. Rebound to Meters. Kwiatkowski kicks it on up. Emma Hepler almost got a piece of it. Addison controls possession. Waits patiently. Kwiatkowski keeps it alive. Some tight defense. Active hands by these Trojans really paying off. Feeds to Faith Rock now in the
full
block, and there's the travel.
So we're under 2.5 to go in this first half. A timeout.
And LaVille will use another timeout.
It's one thing, the video board.
A lot of things to like here.
Video board doesn't have timeouts left up there, so you might have to keep track of them.
Yeah, I will. I know Triton has to take a timeout.
Did you see the IHSAA move the state finals for boys to April 3rd today? Because the original date conflicted with the NCAA tournament.
The March Madness.
Yep.
Oh, yeah, because Indianapolis is going to
host everything.
And they said it was easier to move the full state and only affect the least amount of teams than it was to delay everything from the start, when sectional started.
Whole different look there for the springtime coming.
That makes sense. I'd rather them do it.
When I first read it, I thought they may have pushed everything back to give teams more time to get more games in, but it's not why they did it.
Well, you got 64 teams that got to play and coming to 68 teams got to come play. So Indianapolis will be rocking. Yates down the right wing. She'll drive. Under the basket, takes it herself and puts it in. Yates with a big point there. 17-point lead for the Trojans.
Look at you. You don't even have your cheat sheet today.
Nope.
Not for this game.
No cheat sheet. It's all due to the flashcards. Ashton Brenner, number 23, checking in for the Lancers. Watts also, and she'll get fouled. And she'll go to line for the rare three-point opportunity from the free throw line for three free throws. And now they'll be in the bonus in the next minute, 53 seconds. Got to make sure we highlight that I got my math right. I'll mess it up later, but it was right.
First one was good.
So Watts will set for the second one. Perfect there.
Second one was good.
So far, LaVille only missing one free throw on the evening. Next shot is on its way and perfect from the line. Watts looked like a machine cranking out free throws on that turn there.
7 of 8 for LaVille. 7 of their 9 points came from the free throw line.
Hey, get them how you can get them. Hostrauser to Atkins. To draw up here, Yates now. She'll drive. Goes for a back-to-back baskets. Can't get that one to roll. Rebound's going to go to Meters.
I think that was.
Yep.
Yeah.
Smith now drives. Goes to Faith Rock, kicks out. Ashton Brenner from the corner, can't get it to go. Kinsey Atkins with the rebound. Atkins is going to push it in transition. Waits, goes to Hepler, catch and shoot, three in transition. And the senior hits from straight away to put that lead right back to where it was at. Final minute here of the first half. Triton leads 26-9. Ashton Brenner now, she'll work with it. Kicks back. Watts now hit those last three free throws. Goes to Rock, goes up strong, can't get it to go, and Hostrauser had a paw on it, but couldn't quite bring it in. Inbound goes to Ashton Brenner, now goes down to Faith Rock. Emma Hepler diving for the ball. They're going to get a travel because she rolled over. The Lady Lancers getting a break here, a chance to put up Another basket here on this possession. And a kick ball in the Triton.
Of course, the winner of this game will play the winner of Oregon Davis and John Glenn.
Yep. That'll be a big matchup up there because those are two pretty decent teams.
I don't know.
We played.
Yeah,
Yates takes off. She'll go up. Whoa, there's a travel. She'll pull that pivot foot. Trying to stop with the defense coming out, come down. Right idea. Just couldn't quite keep that pivot foot planted. As Triton has played both teams, they lost to John Glenn to start the season 49-42, then quarantine happened for a while. And Oregon Davis lost 52-37 when they came down to place at the trench.
That Oregon Davis game was closer than that game shows.
Yes, it was.
Those were a lot of free throws hit at the end of that game.
Yep. Well, this Triton team, they upset that John Glenn team a season ago.
Yep.
To find their way to the championship. These girls are hungry for another trip. 3 seconds to go. Yates kicks out. Emma Hepler got to put up a shot. And that's after the buzzer, and Triton's going to take a lead 26-9 into halftime here at the TCU Bi-County Tournament.
You have what the halftime score was the last time they played?
Where's that stat sheet?
Yeah.
He does.
Just curious.
Halftime was 17-8.
So...
we're ahead of schedule.
A little bit ahead of schedule there. So, Coach Heckman's got some work to do at halftime. With that being said, we'll take a break and we'll be right back.
All right.
All right, welcome back. Triton Trojan fans, Andrew here alongside Kaden Atkins, Kenny Barnhart, and the Hall of Famer Orion Lemler. The Trojans lead here at halftime coming into this one by a score of 26-9. Other scores around the area, Bremen and Culver. In that game there, Bremen leads 25-14 at the half. Oregon Davis and John Glenn 32-28 in favor of Oregon Davis. And the Argus New Prairie boys are taken off as it's 22-17, Argus leading in that one. So we'll see what the second half comes here underway. As that one's going to be our first turnover. The 13th turnover for LaVille in this one. As I believe both starting fives are back out there for both teams. Abbey Viers with and Jaelyn Bules both with two fouls, so that's your foul trouble for Triton. As Kinsey Atkins brings it up. Abbey trying to find position down the low block. Yates drives, tries to feed back to her. And that one's off the mark there as Shirk will go to Kwiatkowski. LaVille only one field goal in that first half. 7 points coming from the free throw line. Hostrawser got a piece of that one.
That's Triton's done a really nice job containing those inside and perimeter shots from LaVille.
Triton, six steals, four blocks from the defensive end in that first half. Also out rebounding LaVille 19-13.
So just winning in every statistical category.
So they're looking good here in this first round. There's a travel. Kwiatkowski, she looked to pass it, but pulled it back, or it looked like she was going to take off and decided to pass the last second. Her feet kind of got tied up there. As the Trojans now will take over in their second possession. Looks like, Kenny, you're getting a little bit more of a crowd there for the boys coming up next. It'll be a good one. Here's back to Yates. Thought about the three. She'll take off. Pull-up jumper is on the way. Off the mark. Rebound to Shirk. Shirk with five rebounds on the evening, leading the Lancers in that category. That'll go off the foot of Emma Hepler. Stay here with LaVille. Good defensive stand there. Uh-oh. There he goes.
So both teams scoreless in this first minute and a half.
Rock down at the free throw line. She'll pull up jumper and she'll draw a foul on
Abbey Viers.
That'll be her third personal, and that one goes for Faith Rock. She's perfect from the, she meant one of two from the line earlier. Yep. And Abbey Viers will come out with those three fouls.
And Addyson will come in for her. Addyson then had 6 points in that first half.
And Faith Rock gets the friendly bounce. Lead now to 14.
LaVille is now 8-for-9 from the free throw line in this game.
Leading the Trojans in that statistical yep. category.
Well, not percentages.
Not percentages.
Trojans are perfect.
They're perfect, but seeing that many, nine trips.
Yeah.
So, hey.
One trip.
One of those was a three-point trip.
Five trips to the free throw line.
Atkins now drives. She'll pull back. Goes to Hostrawser, pull-up jumper of the elbow is in for Lexia Hostrawser, and Triton answers right back. Kwiatkowski brings it up. They'll go back to work, see if they can find another field goal on this trip. Meter's shot is off the mark, rebound to Addyson Viers. Yates now with a kick, over to Emma Hepler on the right wing, goes down. Taren Yates. Viers drives, goes up strong, bank is closed. Nice defense there by Lucy Shirk. It's Kwiatkowski now, bring it back up. Addyson feeds Faith Rock down low, lost it there, and Kinsey Atkins comes away with it.
Ooh.
She keeps control of it. On to Emma Hepper, back to Yates. Viers trying to get position down low. As Hepper down the left wing, goes on top to Yates. Atkins patrolling the baseline, comes out. Yates drives off the back iron, too strong. Rebound's gonna go to Shirk. It's her sixth rebound.
Oh, Taren almost got a piece of that one.
Shirk goes up strong and gets the runner to go. Nice play there by Lucy Shirk. Yates now past the half court line, goes over to Emma Hepler. Hepler trying to feed Lexia Hostrawser. That one goes out of bounds on Kwiatkowski. As Bulis will check in for Hostrawser. It's contagious, I'm sorry. Orion, that's why he was doing that. Yeah, I'm
He'll
just saying.
Put it on the broadcast.
Addyson will come out, Watts will come in.
So LaVille leading 5-2 in this quarter.
Got a couple field goals to go.
Yep.
Viers catch and shoot off the back, tie off the backboard, no good.
Yep.
And LaVille takes over. Triton can't be afraid to stay on the gas here in this third quarter and not let LaVille go on a big run.
No, they have to keep that intensity on the defensive end. They looks like they've kind of laxed a little bit and let LaVille get closer back into this one.
Kinsey Atkins gets the steal. She'll take off. On to Hepler. Gotta get a basket on this possession here.
Yeah, regain some momentum. That doesn't mean force something. It means get a good shot.
Yates in the corner. Can't get the bounce. Rebound to Shirk. That'd be 7 for her.
She's looking at double-double if she keeps this up. She leads possibly all scorers with 7. Yeah.
Faith Rock catches in the paint and puts it up there from the lane. 12-point ball game. As all the momentum has shifted to the home hosting Lady Lancers.
And Rock now with 6 points.
Atkins on the left wing. Goes to Yates. Hepler trying to get free from Faith Rock. She's
Look
not going to let the sharpshooter shoot. Addyson Viers gets in low block. She'll try to go up, but they're going to get a foul before the shot. It's trying to inbound. Be the first team foul for LaVille in this half. That'll be on Shirk.
Her third.
That's big, as Cade said, the sophomore's got 7 points. 2 in this quarter.
In.
Atkins just gets it into Yates. Hepler on the right wing goes down to Bules. Bules kick out. Hepler catch and shoot in the corner. Puts it in. And Triton answers back with a big three-pointer there.
Inside out game. It's always there.
It's always there. Just got to go to it. Shirk down the left wing.
I think analytically, statistically speaking, the highest percentage three-pointers come from the inside out.
Yes. Unless you're Steph Curry and they come in from whenever he decides to shoot one.
Whenever you're, you know, across half court.
Yeah. Well, for him, it's just as soon as you take a step. That'll be the third timeout taken by the Lancers. They'll have 2 left. Triton still has all 5 by my count.
So. Your count's right.
You keeping track too?
Yeah.
Oh, well, you're not writing it down. It's all in your head. You still got room up there for that.
All up in this guy here.
As Orion's very comfortable in his producer spot here tonight. Kenny's standing on top of things down up there at LaVille. Still with us, Kenny?
Oh, yeah.
Well, I figured yours away because the camera's still moving.
It's just
Ryan, I'm not so sure of until he got up here and unmuted himself.
Well, I do miss running the camera. That's my specialty.
Well, it's better than me running it. I tend to forget the camera's there and I start watching the game live.
That's why I just watch it on the computer.
Back cut.
Yep.
Back cut. You denied back cut. Don't come out. Back cut.
Bules, now there goes the countdown, just gets it away. Hepler now with it. They're kind of turning a double team. They're not letting Addyson Viers get an easy look. She'll have to lean into one, but she'll have to go to the foul line for another trip. She's perfect on that first one there early in the game.
Is Shirk still in? If that's on her, that's her fourth foul.
And a big foul there for the LaVille as their best rebounder and scorer is coming out.
Yep, that is their fourth.
Team second. Addyson Viers gets the first one to go. Perfect there.
She is 3 for 3. The Trojans are 5 for 5 after that one.
As Addyson will check in. Am I right, Kenny? 22?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. And Lexia Hostrawser now checking in. The Triton. As Addyson Viers perfect from the line there. Is the lead now up 34 to 16. Or 33 to 16.
I missed it. Yeah, I think it's 33.
Watts now on the right wing, trying to work against Yates, and she'll have to walk a tightrope. Kicks out Addyson. Catch and shoot three for her is off the far iron. No good. Rebound to the freshman Addyson Viers. Atkins now with it. We're near the final minute and a half here of the third quarter.
Kickball.
I'll stay right here with Triton as Yates will inbound.
This game's gone pretty quick.
Yeah. Of course, at the boys next.
And we will have appropriate rosters for that one.
Yeah, we want Andy. I thought I could have swore I hit save. Veer's shot is off the mark. Meters with the rebound. Addyson with it. Feeds a rock down the low block. Kicks back to Addyson, thought about the three, pulls back. She'll drive, kick out to Watts. Watts drives, blocked there by Yates. And Kwiatkowski goes back to Rock, out to Addyson. She'll try another three. Can't get that one to go. Rebound to Taren Yates, and it'll be popped out. Knocked away by Kwiatkowski. It'll stay here. Oh, Triton will get hang on to possession. I'm going to put a little bit of pressure here as Watts is going to kind of shadow Kinsey Atkins all the way up the court. Yates drives, kicks back, Viers with the mid-range jumper, puts it in, Addyson Viers.
She has 10 points now.
So she's leading all scores with those 10.
First player to break double digits.
30 seconds to go in the third. Yates Ooh. Knocks that one away. Yates in transition, gonna take it herself, goes up strong and can't get the roll, rebound to Kwiatkowski. And she'll fall to the floor, and I
travel.
And I'll stay here with Triton. Oh, she's okay. That was kind of a hard, kind of weird angle to fall at. So Hostrawser goes to inbound. Goes to Yates in the quarter. Back to Lexia. She'll go up strong. Banks open for her.
She's now up to 8.
10 seconds now. Addyson feeds meters, 5 seconds, goes to Rock, goes back to Addyson, and no one's going to get a shot up, and that's the end of the third quarter. Triton leads 37-16 here at Daly Cox Gymnasium. Kaden looking pretty good, Triton looking good going into that fourth quarter, but they can't remember to let off, they can't let too much off the gas because LaVille went on a pretty good run there starting off the third quarter.
Yeah, they ended up winning that quarter in the end 11-7, so continuing that trend of scoring in the double digits each quarter, but yeah, I mean, you're up 21 coming into the last quarter. It's almost there, but you still have one more quarter to play. You can't just give up on it now.
And LaVille's a team that you got to be careful with fouls. Yeah, you got one team foul, but yeah, you got to be careful because LaVille's a team that showed they can hit pretty good from the free throw line all their trips. Like I said, they only missed one free throw on the night.
Nope, 8 of 9.
Yeah, 8 of 9 from the free throw line. And Triton, yes, yes, they're perfect. But LaVille's a team you don't want to let get down there. I mean, the big thing for LaVille is they don't have Lucy Shirk for a while because she's got those 4 fouls. Won't see her till about maybe the 5-minute mark to go in the fourth quarter.
Yeah,
last before she can come back in.
I bet she comes in first dead ball. And they just trust her to play with those 4 fouls.
Or she's going to come in to start off the fourth.
Yeah.
She's got to be careful of those 4 fouls. Abbey Viers has 3 fouls. She's out there on the back on the floor. Got her and sister Addyson. Emma Hepler, Kinsey Atkins, and Bules out there for Triton. Watts, Addyson, Kwiatkowski, Rock, and Shirk, the 5 out there for the Lady Lancers. The fourth quarter's underway here. this opening game here, the Bi-County Tournament between Triton and LaVille. Atkins now working up top. Wants to go to Hepler there. Miscommunication there as Addyson comes away with it.
Oh, who's Gardner?
Watts out on the right wing. Feeds down low. Shirk's got it. Feeds up to Wytowski. She'll put on the floor. Retreats away from the baseline. On to Watts. Catch and shoot three off the left side there, just off the mark. Bules gets the rebound. Hepler now with it. She'll bring up the floor. Working right.
Look at her. Look at her. Yeah.
Addyson Viers gets it, goes up strong, and banks is open for the freshman. As they stretch the lead there, up 39-16.
So LaVille has 16, Addyson has 12. Here with just under 7 to go in the fourth quarter.
Rock from the left elbow off the mark. Addyson Viers tips it to Bules for the rebound. Hepler coming up again. And Addyson Viers trying to get position. Shirk was like, I'm going to come right in there just in case. Back to Hepler. She had a look. Kicks back to Kinsey Atkins. Back to Bules now. Feeds Abbey Viers down the low block. Back to Bules. On to Addyson Viers.
Back cut.
Keeping on that battle between Abbey Viers and Shirk down low there. Kick out. Kinsey Atkins alone in the corner. Can't get it to go. Abbey Viers with a big rebound there.
Good vision and good pass from Abbey to see the wide open Atkins in the corner.
It's a good look for Kinsey. Well, she doesn't like the corner very much.
No, she does not.
Can't say I don't blame her. That was always my least favorite place to shoot the ball. Addyson Viers goes up strong, and the freshman can't get the roll. Shirk gets the rebound. Watts brings it up. Goes to Addyson. Back to Rock. Kicks out to Kwiatkowski. On to Addyson. Catch and shoot three. Off the mark. Rebound to Shirk. She goes up strong. Gets it to go.
Shirk now to 9 points.
Triton leading by 21 here. 5 minutes to go in the ball game. Hepler will try again. Puts it in. Triton up over 42 now.
Emma's hit three attempts in a row. Good hands. They jump the route.
And after that three, I guess they already did beat it. They put up 38 points against this LaVille team, and now they put up 42 here in the Bi-County against this LaVille team this season. Faith Rock drives off the mark, rebound to Addyson Viers. Sema Hepler will bring it up now with 4.5 to go. Goes to Abbey Viers, catch and shoot the free throw line off the front iron, just short of the mark. Watts with the rebound. She's going to push it here after coach told her to kick it up a gear. Shirk with the deep two and puts it in. She sees double digits in points. Up to Atkins. Addyson Viers trying to get position. Hepler now drives. Goes on top. Looks to go on top to Atkins.
Back cut.
As Faith Rock knocked that pass away from Addyson Viers, LaVille goes back on the attack.
Oop.
Oh, no one was paying attention.
As Lily Smith will check in now for LaVille. As well as Morgan Feldman will check in for Triton.
Jocelynn Faulkner. And
Yates Faulkner. Lena Doll checking in. The JV players won't see a tournament, but they get to come in as reserves here for the varsity game.
That's the nice thing about no JV this year. Some of those tweeners who play both get to only play varsity as opposed to having to, you know, the coaches pick one side or another.
Yep. Foul will be on Lucy Shirk, and I think that's going to do it for her tonight. And that is it for Shirk. Team's third foul. Abbey Viers goes to the line for two.
She will finish with 11 points tonight. And probably close to that 10 rebound mark.
Yeah. Very close. Ashton Brenner and Meters checking in. I hate group text sometimes. Abby can't get the roll to go as the perfection stops there. Should we set for a second one here? Puts the shot up, just off the mark there as Rock gets their empty trip for Triton from the free throw line.
Triton now 6 of 8 at the line.
Yates now the defense on Addyson. To Ashton Brenner with it now, goes up on top. Smith to Addyson. She'll drive, kicks back to Meters. Back to Addyson, goes back to Meters, and she'll work against Abbey Viers. Addyson corner three off the mark. It's off a few players. Someone's got to come with it, and Yates does. Yates now in transition.
Look at Jocelynn. Oh, missed her.
Lena Doll now in the low block, back to Faulkner. On to Yates. Tries to go down low to Abbey Viers, not there. As Ashton Brenner comes away with it now, with 2.5 to go in the ball game. Ashton Brenner out in the corner, goes to Rock.
Good help, get back, good.
They're being patient here. Goes out of bounds off Faith Rock, and Triton takes back over.
So this has been the lowest scoring quarter. They score a 4-5 for the Trojans in this quarter. Back cut, good, filler spot.
Up to Abbey Viers, top the key. Goes to Feldman on the left wing. Down to Lena Doll. Kicks back to Feldman, deep two. Can't get it to go. Tip from Viers to Faulkner, and they keep it alive. Nice play there by Abbey Viers. Doll goes to Yates. She'll drive. Goes down to Addyson Viers. Lena Doll's got an opening look. Bank is closed, unfortunately. But a good look and pass there for Lena Doll. Nice pass from Abbey Viers on that one.
Yep.
Yates initiated. It was nice.
She recognized two girls coming at her, saw the open one, and just unfortunate on the shot.
Addyson misses that one. Rebound's going to go to Feldman. Minute 20 to go. Up to Faulkner. She'll work back to Abbey Viers. Top the key goes to Yates. Faulkner rotates up top the key. Feldman rotates back underneath, back to Feldman. Down to Abbey Viers, here comes the double team. Kicks out Lena Doll. Inside the final minute to go here, Triton will take on the winner of Glenn and Oregon Davis after Yates hits that runner there. So they'll take on the winners, we said, of Oregon Davis and Glenn. And Argus will play the winner of Bremen and Culver.
Oregon Davis was beating Glenn 32-28 at halftime.
So, you know, like I said, big trying a chance. They know what it takes in this tournament after last season's run. And, this group here might have to get another rematch with one of those two teams after they faced them earlier in the season, but it could be a good game.
Yeah, Bremen upset Oregon Davis last year, who I think was the favorite coming into this last year's tournament. And that's how they met up with the Trojans in the championship.
So, you know, hey, this is a group that can – both these groups, I mean, it's Triton knows, like we talked earlier, this is a group that's played pretty much all in that tournament except a handful of freshmen. A lot of these girls, they had that experience last season, so it'll be huge for Coach Heckaman going forward. They have a word down there. It just got really quiet all of a sudden.
Yeah,
well, he muted the mic on his end so we wouldn't get the music.
Oh, gotcha. think Kenny's back.
Yep, that's what I did.
Oh, boy. Watts goes on over to Smith with 43 seconds to go. Ashenbrenner on to Watts. She'll drive back on to Smith. Ashenbrenner drives, goes to meters. Smith with a three. She gets it to go. Yates brings up 20 seconds to go here as Triton will advance in the winner's bracket. As they'll play the Trojan Trench on Wednesday. We said the winner of Glen OD.
We will have that game.
Yes, we Wednesday. Will. We'll be sitting on the couch Wednesday. And that'll do it here as Triton will win 44-23 over the host Lady Lancers. And the boys are up next.
We're going to stay on until we get Wes's stats. Might as well, because we're not going anywhere.
Might as well. We're recording, so.
Or we could just read them off his screen.
Turn around, Wes. Smile.
Or maybe read them off the printer when they come out of the printer. Oh, okay.
I'm quick.
Oh.
I see writing.
Oh, if he just turn it.
Just turns the other way, Wes.
I see. I can't quite read it from here even.
Oh, boy.
If he's going to send it to you or not.
Oh, yep, he is. There he goes. No. Yep, cover that up. We don't want everybody getting my email address. Ryan's going to get ready to take his duties down there.
What? Have John Quinn and Morgan Davis played yet?
They're playing right now.
Oh, we listened to Tony. He probably got a score.
We are recording, so.
Did you get your email yet?
Not yet.
Oh, wait. He might not send them right away because.
Well, he might send it to me.
That's true. He might.
We're doing what we're doing.
He's been sending them at the end of the night.
Yeah. Since there's two games in the game.
Okay, let's just go ahead and read down the leading scores, and we'll go with that, and then we'll switch
okay.
to the other stream. If I get it. You're talking, we'll go with it. Actually, I just got it.
All right. Better.
Even better. All right. So we'll go first for LaVille here. Leading the way with 11 points was Lucy Shirk. Faith Rock with 9 points. And then 3 points there for Cassie Watts. Their leading scorers. They had 25 rebounds. Shirk just one rebound shy of a double-double. Leading the way for Triton with 12 points was Addyson Viers. 9 points for Emma Hepler. 7 points for Taren Yates. 8 points for Lexia Hostrawser. 2 for Abbey Viers and 6 for Kinsey Atkins. Triton 30 rebounds on the night. Won the turnover battle 21-13. Triton 9 steals on the night, 5 block shots, so not a bad way to go. 12 assists, though. That's another big stat. There's a lot of those. We're good passes, Kaden, feeding to some good looks. So yeah,
12 assists, that accounts for at least 24 points.
So that was huge there. So with that being said, we'll get ready to switch streams. We'll get the boys game coming up next here on the Triton Trojan Sports Network.